Yes, students, listen carefully. What is the given first question? The given first question is molarity related conceptual questions. Okay, students, the first question is we have to find out the molarity 4% weight by volume. 4% weight by volume of NaOH they gave. We need to find out its molarity. So in this case, molarity formula is equal to direct formulas also we discussed. That is weight by volume percentage. Weight by volume percentage into 10 divided by gram molecular weight of solute. Okay, students, gram molecular weight of solute. So the gram molecular weight here of solute here NaOH is 40. Okay, then the molarity is equal to 4 into 10 divided by gram molecular weight of NaOH is equal to 40. Means 40 divided by 40 is equals to 1 molar solution it is. 4% weight by volume means 4 grams of NaOH is present in a 100 ml of the solution. Okay, its molarity is equals to 1 molar. It is equals to 1 molar. Okay, students, let's see the second question, dear students. What is the given second question, dear students? The given second question is, we need to find out the number of moles of solute present in 2 liters of NaOH. 2 liters of 0.5 molar NaOH, number of moles we need to find out by using molarity formula. And we know that molarity is equal to number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of the solution, means n molarity is equal to n by v in liters. Then the number of moles is equal to molarity into volume of the solution in liters. So in the question, the volume they given in liters only, and molarity also they gave. So how much molarity they gave, dear student? 0.5 molar they gave, and the volume of the NaOH is equal to 2 liters. So the 0.5 into 2 is nothing but 1. So is nothing but 1, means 1 mole of NaOH is present. So the number of moles is equals to of NaOH is equals to 1. So the answer is second option is correct. Okay, students, let's go for third question, dear students. What is the third question? So the third question is the neutralization formula in terms of molarity. What is the neutralization formula in terms of molarity? Let's see, after that we'll discuss about what is, whether A is correct or R is correct, if what is the relation between A and R we'll discuss. Okay, students, let's see that the given question, third question, 0.1 molar, okay, 0.1 molar of KMnO4 is required to oxidize 20 ml, 0.1 molar oxalic acid is 20 ml they gave. Whether this is correct or not, first we need to find out the KMnO4 is oxidizing agent and oxalic acid is a reducing agent. So first you have to write the ionic equation and you have to balance that ionic equation either in oxidation number method, and we have to find out the how many moles of KMnO4 is involving in how many number of moles of oxalic acid, means balanced equation or number of stoichiometric moles of KMnO4 and oxalic acid first we have to find out. After that we have to use M1V1 by N1 is equals to M2V2 by N2 formula. Okay, students, then we'll get volume. Okay, first ionic formula of MnO4 minus KMnO4 is MnO4 minus. Okay, and oxalic acid ionic formula is C2O4 2 minus. Okay, this reaction is taking place in acidic medium. The KMnO4 is oxidizing agent in acidic medium. It is converted into Mn+2, and oxalic acid is a reducing agent, and C2O4 2 minus is converted into carbon dioxide. Just you have to balance this. For the balancing this, we need to find out its oxidation numbers. So here two carbon atoms are present. That's why 2 moles I am taking. 2 moles of CO2. So other elements first I balanced. Okay, students. Okay, listen carefully. Now just you have to balance this equation, dear students. If you are balancing that, here the oxidation state of manganese is +7. Okay, and here +2 is present. Now here the two carbon atoms, total is 6. And here two carbon atoms, the total is 8. The difference in their oxidation states is 7 minus 2 is equals to 5. And here the difference is 8 minus 6 is equals to 2. So this equation you have to multiply it with 2. This equation you have to multiply it with 5. Then we'll get a skeleton balanced equation, that is 2 moles of MnO4 minus plus 5 moles of oxalic acid C2O4 2 minus is converted into 2 moles of Mn plus 2 plus 5 to the 10 moles of carbon dioxide it will form. Okay, student, this is the skeleton balanced equation. Now in which here 2 moles of KMnO4 is present, and it's the 2 moles of KMnO4 is required for the complete neutralization of 5 moles of oxalic acid is required, H2C2O4. Now if you observe that in that region R, the 2 moles of KMnO4 is equals to 5 moles of oxalic acid, they said. So that's why R is correct. Now whether the A is correct or not, first we need to check. Okay, students, let's see that formula is equals to M1V1 by N1 is equals to M2V2 by N2. Okay, that M1V1 by N1, let you have to think, it is about KMnO4 values and it is about oxalic acid values H2C2O4. Now that KMnO4 molarity they gave 0.1, and volume we need to check whether it is the 20 ml is coming or not. 0.1 by V1 by number of moles is equals to 2 is equals to 0.1 into 20 divided by the number of moles of oxalic acid is 5. From this the V1 is equals to 0.1 into 20 into 2 divided by 5 into 0.1. This 0.1 and 0.1 will cancel, and is on simplification we'll get 8 ml. Okay, students, 8 ml we are getting, but in the question how much volume they said, the 0.1 molar KMnO4 is required to oxidize 20 ml of 0.1 molar oxalic acid in acidic medium is 20 ml they said, but is not 20 ml. The correct one is 8 ml only is enough, but that's why A is false. A is false statement and R is a true statement. So like option is where it is present, dear students, fourth option is a correct. Okay, so the third question answer is a fourth. Let's see that fifth question, dear students. What is the given fifth question, dear students? The given fifth question is, fourth question is, the given fourth question, if you observe that it's very easy only, dear students. Just see, 250 ml means you have to take one beaker. In this beaker, they are making 250 ml of solution. 250 ml of sodium carbonate. Na2CO3 they are preparing, and the weight is 2.65 grams. Okay, now we need to find out its molarity. The molarity is equals to weight by 2.6 by gram molecular weight of Na2CO3. The gram molecular weight of sodium carbonate is equals to 106 into 1000 by volume of the solution. The volume is 250 ml. Is on simplification. Its molarity is equals to 0.1 molar will comes. Okay, students. Now they are taking in another beaker, from this its concentration how much, dear students? 0.1 molar. So they are used 0.1 molar Na2CO3 and 10 ml. So how much they took, ma'am? 10 ml they took, and they added externally x ml of water. X ml of water they added, and its final concentration they gave. By the addition of x ml of water, its concentration is equal to its molarity, final molarity, and final M2 is equals to 0.001 molar came. And what is X value? X value we need to find out. For this dilution law we need to use. What is dilution law, dear students? The dilution law is equals to M1 V1 is equals to M2 V2. Then the final volume first we need to find out. After that, how much amount of added water is equals to V2 minus V1. So the M1 is equals to 0.1 molar. Okay, 0.1, and how much initially they took? 10 ml they took, and M2 becomes 0.001, and its volume is equals to V2. That V2 we need to find out. So then the V2 is equals to 0.1 into 10 divided by 0.001 is nothing but, the V2 is nothing but 1000 ml will come. Okay, student, the finally, by the addition of x ml of water, the final volume of the solution is equals to 1000 ml. Its concentration becomes 0.001 molar came. So the volume of water added, the volume of water H2O is added is equals to x is equals to V2 minus V1. So the V2 is equals to 1000 ml minus V1 is equals to 10, then it is equals to 990 ml will get. Okay, student, the answer is a second option is a correct. Okay, let's go for fifth question, dear students. The fifth question, we need to find out the how many number of moles of copper is formed. That we need to find out. Here limiting reagent concept also we need to applicable. Okay, so the fifth question is, zinc metal is reacting with copper sulfate, okay, to form zinc sulfate, and copper is formed, and this zinc they took, excess of zinc they took. So the excess means the limiting reagent LR is copper sulfate. LR is the copper sulfate. So if it is 1 mole of copper sulfate, 1 mole of copper sulfate forms 1 mole of copper. Okay, but how much amount of copper sulfate they took, dear students? They took 100 ml, 0.05 molar copper sulfate they added. Then we need to find out how many number of moles of copper is forming, that we need to find out. So in 100 ml 0.05 molar copper sulfate containing number of moles, that n is equals to number of moles, that n is equals to molarity into volume in liters, volume in liters. The molarity is 0.05, and 100 ml means 0.1 liter, then it is equals to 0.005 moles. Okay, students, 1 mole copper sulfate is forms 1 mole of copper, then 0.005 moles is also forms, in just you have to do cross multiplication, that is also is equals to 0.005 moles of copper will form, because both the limiting reagent is 1 mole is present, and product is also 1 mole will form. The limiting reagent is 0.05 moles, then the product is also in the same proportion, means 0.05 moles. So the answer is a fourth option is correct. Okay, students, so here limiting reagent concept we are used, and the molarity and volume first, the given molarity of copper sulfate and volume of the copper sulfate we are converted into number of moles. And in the stoichiometric balanced equation, 1 mole of copper sulfate is produced to 1 mole of copper. But in the given solution containing number of moles of copper sulfate is equals to 0.005. That's why the amount of copper is formed is also is equals to 0.005 moles only. 0.005 moles of copper is forming. Okay, students. Let's see the sixth question, dear students. Sixth question, already in first year only we have discussed what is the molarity of the pure water. The molarity of the pure water, it is a fixed question, is equals to 55.55 molar. Why it is 55.55 molar, dear students? The density of water, is equals to 1 gram per ml. Means 1 gram of, means 1 gram of H2O is equals to 1 ml of H2O. Okay, students. So according to that, its molarity means weight of water we know that, and volume of water is also know that. In the same way, similarly, you have to take 1000 grams of water. 1000 grams of water means 1 liter is equals to 1000 ml. 1000 ml of water. Okay, students. So now this case, molarity of pure water is equals to weight. A weight you have to take this 1 gram or 1000 grams also no problem. For example, one only you took, weight by gram molecular weight of water is 18 into 1000 by volume. 1 gram of H2O means 1 ml. It is 1 ml is nothing but 1000 by 18 is nothing but 55.55 molar will comes. Okay, in the same way, for example, otherwise you are taking that the weight of H2O is equals to 1000 grams, then the volume of H2O is equals to 1000 ml. Okay, volume 1000 ml, then the molarity is equals to weight 1000 by 18 into 1000 by volume is also 1000 ml. Then is also is equals to 1000 by 18 only will comes. Then it is equals to 55.55 molar only will come. That's why the pure water molarity is equals to 55.55 molar. Okay, students, let's see the seventh question, dear students. What is the given seventh question? The given seventh question is, if 250 ml of 0.25 molar NaCl solution is diluted with water to the volume of 500 ml, the new concentration of the solution, means final volume, means 250 ml, some certain concentration of NaCl is diluting. After that, it volume is becomes 500 ml. Then under that condition, what is the concentration of NaCl we need to find out? Okay, students, it is the dilution law. In this condition, the formula is equals to M1V1 is equals to M2V2. The formula is equals to M1V1 is equals to M2V2. So initial molarity is equals to 0.25 molar, means 0.25 molar of NaCl. Its volume is equals to 250 ml. Then the final volume M2 value we need to find out, and its final volume is equals to 500 ml. Then the M2 is equals to 0.25 into 250 divided by 500. Okay, is on simplification we'll get 0.125 molar. Okay, so by the addition of how much amount of water they added, dear students, initially 500 ml of water is there and final volume is 500, means they're added here, the x is equals to 250 ml water, just they're added. If the 250 ml water they're added, then it is finally becomes 500 ml. Then automatically double amount they're added, means 250 becomes 500, double, then the concentration becomes half, means 0.25 is converted into 0.125 molar. So the seventh question answer is third option is correct. Okay, students, let's see the eighth question, dear students. What is the given eighth question? The given eighth question is, What is the given eighth question, dear students? If you observe that the given eighth question, what volume of 0.8 molar solution contains 0.1 moles of solute? 0.1 mole of solute is present. Then volume we need to find out. The volume they given in ml. Okay, molarity they gave. The molarity is equals to n, number of moles by volume in liters. Then is nothing but the molarity is equals to number of moles into volume in ml. Number of moles into 1000 divided by volume in ml. So the answers in the options, the volume they gave in ml only, that's why in n into 1000 divided by volume in ml I took. So we need to find out the volume of the solution. We need to find out. Then the volume in ml is equals to number of moles into 1000 divided by molarity of the solution. The number of moles already they gave, so that is 0.1 mole. 0.1 into 1000 divided by the molarity of the solution also they gave, that is 0.8 molar. 0.8 molar. Okay students, now the answer is on simplification, is nothing but 1000 divided by 8. Is on simplification, we'll get 125 ml. So the final means what is the volume of the solution when 0.1 mole of solute present having its concentration is 0.8 molar. The molarity is 0.8 and number of moles is equals to 0.1 mole. Then the volume of the solution is equals to 125 ml or 0.125 liters. Okay, so the answer is the second option. Okay, let's see, dear students, ninth question. These all are basic fundamental questions only, completely related to molarity and normality and mole fraction concept, conceptual questions, and very easy also and important also. Okay students, ninth question, let's see. The ninth question is the ninth question. This model already we are discussed in a fourth question. So 250 ml of calcium carbonate is present. So the volume is equals to 250 ml of calcium carbonate. CaCO3 is present and its weight is equals to, they gave how much weight they gave, dear students? 2.5 grams of calcium carbonate they gave. Now from this 10 ml of solution they took, V1 is equals to 10 ml. Okay, and M1 we need to find out that molarity. What is M1 value? That M1 value is equals to weight by gram molecular weight of Na2CO3 is equals to 100 into 1000 by volume is 250 ml. Is on simplification, we'll get 0.1 molar. Okay, now this is volume is 0.1 molar. Okay, it's very clear. Now 10 ml of this 0.1 molar solution, how much we have initially? 250 ml. We have from this 250 ml, they took 10 ml and concentration is 0.1 ml, and it is they diluted the solution, they diluted into 1 liter. Then how much, what is the resultant concentration they said? So the V2 is equals to 1 liter is nothing but 1000 ml. Then the final concentration M2 we need to find out. So the formula is equals to M1V1 is equals to M2V2. M1V1 is equals to M2V2. The M1 is equals to 0.1 into V1 is equals to 10. And M2 we need to find out, M2 into 1000. Okay, then M2 is equals to 0.1 into 10 divided by 1000. Okay students, this is nothing but is on simplification, we'll get 0.001 molar. So the answer is second option. Now let's see that 10th question, dear students. What is the given 10th question? The given 10th question is 3.65 grams of HCl is dissolved in 16.2 grams of water, and we have to find out the mole fraction of HCl. We need to find out. So the mole fraction of HCl is equals to number of moles of hydrogen chloride by number of moles of HCl plus number of moles of water. Okay, and weight of HCl they gave, that is 3.65 divided by 36.5. The gram molecular weight of HCl is 36.5 divided by 3.65 divided by 36.5 plus the weight of water is 16.2 grams divided by weight of gram molecular weight of water is 18 is on simplification is nothing but 0.1 divided by 0.1 plus 0.9. The denominator is becomes 1. 0.1 by 1 is nothing but 0.1 mole fraction. So the mole fraction of HCl is equals to 0.1. So the mole fraction of HCl, hydrochloric acid, is equals to 0.1. And the mole fraction of water you want means 1 minus the mole fraction of HCl. But actually water mole fraction they are not asked, but how to calculate means the sum of the mole fractions of the all components is equals to 1. So the total is equals to 1. From 1 minus mole fraction of HCl you do, then we'll get the mole fraction of water. 1 minus 0.1 is equals to 0.9 will come. So the total sum of the mole fractions of all components in a solution is equals to 1. Already we know that. So the answer for the here in the question, mole fraction of HCl only they asked, that value is 0.1 molar. Okay, students, let's see the 11th question, dear students. What is the given 11th question? The given 11th question is, the formula weight or gram molecular weight of H2SO4 is 98. The amount of acid present in 400 ml 0.1 molar HCl they are asked. So the weight we need to find out. Let's see the 11th question, dear student. The 11th question is molarity formula. Molarity is equals to weight by gram molecular weight of solute into 1000 by volume of the solution in ml. Okay, from this weight of H2SO4 we need to find out in 500 ml of the solution with 0.1 molar. So the gram weight of H2SO4 is equals to molarity into gram molecular weight into volume in ml divided by 1000. Okay, the molarity they gave in the question is 0.1 and the gram molecular weight is 98 and the volume is equals to 400 ml divided by 1000. Is on simplification we'll get is on simplification we are getting 3.92 grams. So the answer is second option. Okay, students, let's see the 12th question, dear students. What is the given 12th question, dear students? The given 12th question is, the given 12th question is 5.85 grams of NaCl is dissolved in 500 ml of water. The molarity they are asked. So the molarity of NaCl is equals to weight by 5.85. The gram molecular weight of NaCl. NaCl gram molecular weight is sodium 23 and chlorine 35.5. The total is equals to 58.5 into 1000 divided by volume of solution is 500 ml. Is on simplification. We are getting 0.2 molar. So the answer is second option. Let's see the 13th question, dear students. The 13th question is the amount of FeSO4 7H2O. FeSO4 7H2O gram molecular weight they gave. Just we have to find out the weight. So in this case, the weight is equals to molarity into gram molecular weight of solute into volume of the solution in ml divided by 1000. Okay, so the molarity of the FeSO4 7H2O is equals to 0.1 they gave, and its gram molecular weight is 278, and the volume of the solution is equals to, the volume of the solution is equals to 100 ml divided by 1000 divided by 1000. Is on simplification, we'll get the weight of FeSO4 7H2O is equals to 2.78 grams. 2.78 grams is the answer. Okay, students, let's see the 14th question, dear students. The 14th question is, what they are asked, number of milli equivalents in the given volume and normality they gave. We know very well, dear students, the normality is equals to number of equivalents. Number of equivalents divided by volume of the solution in liters. Then the number of equivalents is equals to normality into volume in liters, but they are asked milli equivalents. That's why you have to take that volume in a ml. So that number of milli equivalents is equals to normality into volume in ml. Normality into volume in ml. The given normality is 0.2 normal, and volume milli equivalent they asked 0.5 liters is nothing but 500 ml. Just you have to take 500 ml. Okay, now you have to multiply 0.2 into 500 is nothing but 100 will come, 100 milli equivalents. Okay, students, now the answer is 100. So instead of that 100 milli equivalents, how many equivalents are present? Means 0.2 into 0.5 we need to do. 0.2 into 0.5 is nothing but 0.1 is the answer. 0.1 is the answer. Okay, so milli equivalents means the volume we need to take in ml. Number of equivalents they asked means the volume we have to take in liters. Okay, let's see, dear students, 15th question. What is the given 15th question, dear students? The given 15th question is the volume of potassium dichromate we need to find out is oxidized, required to oxidize ferrous sulfate. Okay, and ionic form you have to write first, the skeleton balanced equation you have to write, potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 and iron sulfate means Fe+2, iron oxidation state. It is oxidizing agent and ferrous sulfate is reducing agent. Then that potassium dichromate is converted into chromium 3+, and 2 chromiums will come, and iron+2 is converted into iron+3. So just you have to balance the skeleton equation, then change in the oxidation states. The 2 chromiums oxidation state is 12 and iron+2, and total 2 chromium 3+ means 6, and 3 will come here. 3, the difference in their oxidation state means then we'll get, find out n factor value. So sorry, dear students, this chromium, this is will comes. So this is 12 minus 6 is equals to 6, and this is 3 minus 2 is equals to 1. This equation we have to multiply with 6, and this equation we have to multiply with